It is extraordinary watching these pictures because it brings together that moment when many, many people must be just trying to pull together their thoughts for the whole of this week, a week that certainly Britain has never known, and a week which, it has to be said, has been shared in extraordinary numbers of countries across the world. Look at the swelling of the crowd now as the people move right across the road. The police have opened the road and the people are coming out in their hundreds across the road, packing into the central reservation. Others running across ahead, across the cycle routes in Kensington, in a way almost caught by surprise, as if they didn't know this was going to happen. And I'm sure they didn't know it was going to happen. This has been something which the vast majority of people wouldn't know was going to happen. Most people are preparing for tomorrow to see the cortege come the other way, to come back down this route and into the park and out across the Mall to Westminster Abbey. But here suddenly they get probably a better sight than they will ever get tomorrow of the person that so many thoughts are focused upon in this hour. I mean, when you look at these numbers, when you look at these heads, most of which are hidden from us because of the sheer darkness of the night, and imagine what is to come tomorrow. This will be the field either side of the procession, right across a 2-mile focus of London.
Now the camera pulling back just to give some sense of the sheer numbers of people who have gathered there.